Adding an LCD readout to an Arduino project is a sure way to make it a whole lot better. I'm using a 20 by 4 four-wire display here, and I'm using it to read a degree C and degree from a simple project that I'm working on. Finding the pinout location and the .h files can be challenging for these things. This is for the SaneSmart LCD module, like I said, the 20 by 4. Pins are the VCC, ground, SCL, and SDA. Also, I've got some notes in here that if you don't have an SCL and SDA on your Arduino board, you can hook those to A4 and A5. First thing that you're going to need to do is get your libraries. You can download some .h files from a variety of places on the web here. It took me a while to find this Liquid Crystal file that has the Liquid Crystal I2C, H, and the CPP files. Make sure you're using those and not the Liquid Crystal. I think they're for a different display. As with everything, you're going to have to kind of hack and whack your way through these things. Hopefully this will make things a little bit easier. And of course, your .h files for wire and CPP. I think this comes with the actual Arduino controller. Once you have those added, make sure you have, when you add your libraries, make sure your software is not running, otherwise Arduino won't recognize it. Then you can simply add these, the Liquid Crystal, and we'll add the include statements for you in your project. A little bit about how I wired this thing up. One of the main reasons I bought this particular LCD from SaneSmart is that the few numbers of Arduino ports that it takes up. It only takes the SCL and the SDA. Everything else is free to use. So once you hook up the those two ports, the VCC and the ground, just a little bit of code, you're up and running with this thing. For my thermistor, I'm using a typical voltage divider configuration, where my thermistor is actually R2, so algebraically I just need to solve for that. The Arduino will measure the voltage across R2, then I can compute R2, then I can feed R2 into the equation specified by the manufacturer. Also, since I'm actually hooking voltage right to ground, you want to make sure that you're using large enough resistors, otherwise you might suck too much current out of your Arduino. Two 10K resistors, I'm actually using way less than the 40 milliamp output that the Arduino can supply. Alright, now get to the code here. Here's your typical include statements, the wire.h and the Liquid Crystal. If you're not used to C code, it is all case sensitive. The pound definitions, this is the big number right here, the hex 27. I found an example on the internet that had the wrong hex, so mine actually never worked. I had to find another example to figure out what that correct value was. I wanted to put a cute little degree symbol in my on my LCD readout, so I just defined a 8-byte array and just typed in the values that I thought would make the little degree symbol. Of course, some floats for various things that I'm reading and calculating, and some character data, and of course some code to actually fire up the Liquid Crystal display. The setup here is fairly routine. Serial.begin if you want to write any data to your serial monitor. And of course, here's the magical equations that I got from my thermistor. So if you want to use the thermistor, you're going to have to get a data sheet from the manufacturer and look for something in there for the equation on that if you put in the resistance that you've measured, actually you're measuring the voltage and calculating the resistance, then you can put that into this giant equation right here to get the actual temperature in degrees K from the thermistor. All those constants are somewhere in that data sheet, so make sure you get that data sheet before you try doing anything with your thermistor. Then it's just a matter of typing in all of that equations and math to get the all the thermistor readings correct. Most of the code here is actually for the thermistor. Anything with LCD is stuff that you're going to need to type in for your to get your display to work. So in my setup code here, I'm actually typing in or displaying things like temp, degrees F, degrees C, temperature monitor. I just don't want to write that every single time in my loop. That way I can just write just the data that changes, like the actual numbers that you see changing on the screen. Now when we get to the void loop function, we do read the volts in the analog. Again, this is from the thermistor, so I have to go to convert that volts to the real volts, the A volts. Then I convert that to what that corresponding resistance is for R2 from the voltage divider. Then I can convert or compute what the actual temperature in degrees K is, and once I get that, then I can get degrees C and of course degrees F. Then the rest of it is all firing up the LCD and outputting that data to the LCD so I can see what the values are. And of course, I've got a delay of half a second in here just so I don't have this thing firing off too many updates. That way I can actually read my LCD. Well, that's it. That's how you use an LCD, a 20x4, with your Arduino. Thanks for watching.